Currentfootball.com.au Coaches Catch-Up Series continues. We're out at Bannockburn, time to talk to their coach, Craig McGough. Craig, thanks for joining us. Last year obviously ended on a disappointing note. You were right in the thick of finals contention up to the final round and just couldn't sneak in, and I suppose that would be something that motivates you to really go into this year.
Yeah, definitely. Look, I think the last couple of games, the age of physically, they just couldn't get out of the line the last couple of weeks. And we had a few injuries and didn't have the depth last year. We had a couple of weeks of the season.
Is that something you identified when you went recruiting, that you just needed to add to that depth, and hopefully that will be enough to take the next step and make sure you're playing in September?
Yeah, look, we, over the course of the season, just identified some areas we thought we were deficient in. And certainly one of those was experience, and we think we brought in some bigger, smaller bodies this season to help out the development of the young players and ensure that at the back end of the season we're still able to physically cope with the contest.
One of those biggest, smaller bodies, of course, is Tom Lane Grant, who returns to the club after two or three seasons away. Last time he was here, he was good for 70 or 80 goals a season. No doubt you'd be hoping for the same.
Oh, yeah, look, we certainly haven't put any goalkeeping expectations, but playing full forward, the way he plays the game, hopefully and hopefully we'll get in the forward half, he'll contribute pretty well.
You have been fairly quiet other than Tom Lane Grant. Have you any other recruits of note that you can give to us and to our viewers?
Well, look, we targeted six players and we've picked up all of those. And then we've had a number of five or six former players that we spoke to over a period of time that have come back to the footy club. Probably the significant ones being Wood. We missed last year. Dave Watson, who was a Port Adelaide listed player in 2007, I think it was. He's relocating from Sydney in a few weeks, so he's a very hard midfielder, probably 4 years, so he'll be exceptionally good for us.
And obviously on the negative side, not too many losses, although talent against too many type, and obviously you've got to have a crack at the GFL.
Yeah, made a decision to move on, and look, sometimes these are for the benefit of both the player and the club. And lost Matty, probably didn't have his greatest season last year. It was probably beneficial for him to find the other club at this point.
Any other losses of note?
No, look, we think that every player we want to keep at the footy club is still here. You know, if you're a player that's not focused on the team result, then you're probably not playing on the spot. And the guys that
getting the next step, you talk about experienced bodies, but it's one of the close ones as well. There was a number of games last year you probably reflected on, probably not at the time, but looked back on come September and gone, gee, you know, kick this way or kick that way, you would have been playing in finals.
Yeah, probably three or four games we as far as scoring shots and inside 50s, we beat the opposition but weren't able to positively hit the scoreboard. A couple of reasons for that: inexperience, probably a little bit of pressure tank with the ball, but also a lack of a couple of key forwards that can finish, and we think we've addressed that this year, bringing in some experience and some quality goalkeepers, and they'll take a bit of pressure off the other players, and hopefully the experiences of last year will make them stick moving forward.
Your second season in charge, has it been easier this pre-season, obviously knowing the lay of the land and most of the playing group better than you did 12 months ago?
Oh, absolutely. When I took them to the last year, I was well aware where the football club was at, and sort of an exodus of quite a number of players and experienced players. So we made the decision just to develop kids last year, and as it stands now, it's probably been the smartest thing to do. We asked some really good kids last year, have had a solid pre-season, and physically developed, and getting a better understanding how we want to play, and of course, we put the experienced players around, and we're hoping that they'll take another step next season.
Winchelsea, Thompson, Inverleigh and North Geelong to open up. So a couple of clubs that are regular in the woods last year. Inverleigh obviously yeah. Struggled and then the reigning premier.
Yeah, look, I think the first 6 weeks are going to be really challenging for us, and we'll get a bit of an idea on how far we've come along and where our expectations should be as far as finals aspirations and those sort of things. We'll have a bit of guide on come around 6 or 7.
Fantastic, Craig. We appreciate the time. Wish you the best of luck, hopefully for your sake. Another step up the ladder, and featuring in the finals is the end result for the Bannockburn Footy Club. Good luck.
Yeah, no worries, mate. Thanks very much, and good luck for your season.
Craig McGough joining us here at Coaches Catch-Up, parafootball.com.